Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 7 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, we imported two movie files with different resolutions, and I showed you how to make them work well together. But something became very apparent after we did the import, and that is, the more video strips we have in our sequencer, the slower Blender becomes. And that's because we are rendering the full resolution of the videos in our preview window, and we don't have to do that. We can actually set up video proxies that will actually allow us to run a lower resolution version of the video in the preview window, and this will not affect in any way the final render of our video because it will always use the highest quality version. It will only make the performance in the preview window go up. So let's get started by configuring the proxies for our videos by going down to the video strip down here, selecting it with our right mouse button, and we're going to go down to the bottom of this properties window, and we have an option down here. It's called proxy timecode. We're going to put a check mark in there, and you'll notice that you have four options. You have 25%, 50%, 75%, or 100%. Now, this will shrink the file that we're viewing down to 25% of the original, 50% of the original, 75% of the original, or it will recompress it at 100%, but it will be a little bit easier to render. I would recommend that you actually use 50%. It's not going to look great, but it will be good enough for you to do the editing. So we'll select that. And now all you have to do is go over to the strip menu and select rebuild proxy and timecode indices. Now this is going to take a little bit of time, so I'm going to skip ahead to now. Now that took about 1 minute for my computer to recompress the video. And all we have to do now is switch to that video in our preview window. And the way that we do that is we go down to this view menu and we select properties. And you'll see an option for proxy render size, and we'll just switch to proxy size 50%. Now you notice that the actual visual quality dropped, but what you're really going to notice is when you drag the green line across the sequencer, it is super fast. That's way better than how it was previously. I guarantee it. Now you just need to remember that you need to actually set up a proxy for every video strip that you actually have in your sequencer. And you have to also make sure that they're all set to the exact same percentage. So I think that should actually be enough stuff for today. I will see you guys in the next video.